It is about to be even easier to own a gun in Texas, because apparently it was hard before. Governor Greg Abbott is continuing to push to make Texas pretty much the most pro-life, pro-death state in the entire union. Texas lawmakers have passed a bill that would allow residents to carry handguns without a license, background check, or training, sending the legislation to Governor Greg Abbott's desk to sign. And the state Republican-dominated legislature approved of the measure. And Greg Abbott says he's gonna sign it, despite, of course, objections. Mind you, this is the first time that the legislature has met since the El Paso shooting that killed 23 people. So
wow.
So just a little bit more context about what current laws say in Texas. Current law in Texas requires owners to be licensed to carry a handgun, both concealed and open. Applicants are also required to submit fingerprints, complete 4 to 6 hours of training, pass a written exam, and then pass a shooting proficiency test. Does that mean like you have to shoot good to own a gun? can you hit this target? That feels scary. Anyway, all that doesn't matter because apparently all of those things are going away. So you don't need a license to carry a handgun. You don't have to submit fingerprints. No written exam and definitely not a shooting proficiency exam. So prepare for bullets to fly. This can only work out great. So what was already happening in Texas? Texas already allows rifles to be carried without a public license or in public without a license. So this just applies to handguns. And the measure they sent Greg Abbott would allow anyone age 21 or older to carry a handgun as long as they do not have a felony criminal conviction or some other legal prohibition in their background. Now, see, that's something that I don't understand. So it's like you don't have any database for any way to track the gun owners. But you are gonna prohibit them if they have a felony criminal conviction or some kind of other like prohibition. I'm not even sure how all this is gonna work. Of course, the NRA celebrated it. And whenever the NRA celebrates anything, it's scary as hell. They called it the most significant gun rights measure in the state's history. The measure is opposed, of course, by law enforcement groups who say it would endanger the public and police. Gun control groups also oppose the measure, noting the state's recent history of mass shootings, including those at an El Paso Walmart, a church in Sutherland Springs, and a high school outside of Houston. Thoughts on Dr. Richey?
Yeah, these people crazy as hell. You know, they're so insane that they have made friends of police officers and those that are gun reform advocates or gun control advocates. So literally, you have the policing community and the gun control community saying the same thing because of how insane the Texas legislation is that has been presented. And here's what's wild about this kind of legislation. They say this is a freedom. Right? Having a gun is a constitutional right. So anytime you have more freedom to have more guns or you have the ability to get a gun without some level of bureaucracy involved, that somehow equates to freedom. Let me show you how ridiculous that is. We have a lot of constitutional rights. I have the freedom of assembly. I have the freedom of speech. But all of those freedoms come with restrictions.
Yeah.
If I yell fire, use my freedom of speech. If I yell fire, there's no fire. People get injured, I can be arrested, right? My freedom of speech has a limitation. Every freedom you have has a limitation. Every right you have has a common sense regulation. No one says these regulations are speech control.
Yeah.
No one says this is assembly control, right? You can't assemble in my front yard. That's my private property. As soon as your right starts to interfere with mine, we have a problem, right?
Yeah.
So look at the right to bear arms. That is a right. Technically, bearing arms also meant knives back then, but that's a different argument. You have the right to bear arms. But your right.
I wish it were just knives now.
Right, exactly. But your right to bear arms, does it interfere with my right of liberty? Yes, it can. And if it interferes with my right to liberty, we now have a constitutional problem and we must have common sense regulation in order to make sure they can coexist as rights in the United States. And that's what Texas is eliminating. They are eliminating the common sense barriers that are involved with your constitutional rights. It's the equivalent of saying your freedom of speech is now unlimited.
Yeah.
You can put hits out on people. You can yell fire in crowded buildings and get people injured. You can incite riots with your speech now because we are eliminating the barrier of your freedom of speech. That is the equivalent of what they're doing in Texas.
This is, I mean, and this is one thing where I'm like, back to Biden and the lack of an executive order. Just background checks, increase background checks, eliminate, you know, the ghost guns where people can like 3D print whatever gun they want to do, right? Like this is where, because this Texas state law cannot override federal law. So that's super important to remember. So if you actually want to keep people safe, the Biden administration can do that right now. And talk about an issue that is like, I mean, we've been talking about a lot of supposed hot button issues, you know, qualified immunity, Israel, Palestine, gun control. In the year 2021, after this many mass shootings, after like we're, you know, a month out of quarantine and, you know, we've got more mass shootings than we've had in like 3 years or whatever, like this is not a controversial issue. This is something that he will be applauded for, heralded. He might even win a Nobel Prize, you know, like why not? You know, he's Obama adjacent. Like, you know, like this, it's such a no-brainer to me. And I'm also like, where is Texas headed? Like, okay, so all abortions are criminalized. They just passed a law that is saying that you can't learn about racism in classrooms. So cool. So like that eliminates most of American history. And then now this. So it's just like, I feel like Greg Abbott has like this death wish. Like he's just like pummeling towards some sort of abyss here.
Yeah. Yeah, you gotta think about how ironic it is that they're passing laws. Just think about the laws to eliminate critical race theory as curriculum. First of all, K through 12 educators don't really teach critical race theory.
No.
I'm a college professor. I teach critical race theory at the university. And I teach critical race theory as a prerequisite so you can understand the context of bias in America. And that could be a business context, a political context, sometimes even a social context. But yeah. It encourages you to critically and analytically think about race and racism in the United States. It's basically history in a theoretical framework. Now, they are passing laws to make it illegal for certain curriculum to be taught. Think about what they have not passed a law for. In these states that say it is now illegal to teach critical race theory, there's no law saying you cannot teach white supremacy is a positive thing. There is no law that says you cannot teach that the Holocaust was a hoax. You are legally able to teach these ridiculous ideologies in these states. Mm-hmm. But the one thing you cannot teach is critical race theory, the history of racism in a theoretical framework in the United States of America. That is now against the law in states around this country.
Once again, heart goes out to Texas. I've said this 2 days in a row now.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.